Greetings everyone. In this video, I am going to introduce you the latest Stability AI released Stable Cascade model. The weights are released. I know that there is Stable Diffusion 3, but its weights are not released. Its models are not released yet. Therefore, today I am going to show you how to use this amazing model, the weights, the models published by the Stability AI. It is called as Stable Cascade and it is really amazing. We have developed an amazing Gradio application for this model. So this model right now works on even 5 GB VRAM having GPUs, even on older GPUs. Therefore, even if you have a low VRAM having GPU, you will be able to use this amazing model both locally, and if you don't have any GPU, you will be able to use it on cloud. Because we also have cloud installers, we also have a Kaggle notebook, so you can use this on your computer or on cloud as you wish. In today's video, I am going to show you how to one-click install this amazing Gradio application and start using Stable Cascade on your computer on Windows. So the application that we have developed for the Stable Cascade is amazing. It includes all the features that you need. It supports multi-line prompting. You see each line is treated as a separate prompt. It supports negative prompt. It supports 275 different styles, so you can generate images in any style that you wish. It supports loop all styles. This is a very necessary feature if you want to test all of the styles on your prompt and see which one is performing best. It supports randomized seed, it supports different resolutions, it supports batch size and also number of images to generate. So you can generate 100 images, 200 images with your prompts as you wish. It supports CFG values for prior guidance scale and decoder guidance scale. The Stable Cascade works with two steps. It is prior steps and also decoder steps. There is also prior inference steps and decoder inference steps. So the guidance scale determines how much it should follow the prompt, and the steps, as we know, how many steps it will take to render the image. Moreover, this application saves the metadata of every generated image, so you can load any image from your outputs and you can see the metadata of that image like this. It also allows you to load and set metadata settings with one click, so all the settings that you have used to generate that image will be loaded here. So how we are going to install this application on Windows? To download and install this application on your Windows, you need to go to the very bottom of this post and download the latest version attached zip file. The link of this post will be in the description of the video. So click the link in the bottom. This is the attachment link. Then cut the downloaded zip file, move into the folder wherever you want to install. I'm going to install into my F drive. Right click, extract the Stable Cascade version 12. Then enter inside here. So at this point, you just need to double click Windows install.bat file and it will start the automatic installation for you. However, there are few requirements that you have to do before start installing this amazing application. You need to have Python 3.10 and Git to be installed. How you are going to be sure that you have installed them? When you type Python, you should see 3.10.x. I suggest 11. 11 is the working best one. If you have multiple Python versions, but also installed Python launcher, which is default installation, it will still work. And you also need to have installed Git. So when you type Git into a CMD window, you should get Git output like this. If you don't know how to install Python, Git, I have an excellent tutorial that covers all of these step by step. The link is here. Python, Git, FFmpeg, and C++ tools. Just follow this amazing, very recent tutorial and install everything shown here exactly as that way, and you will be able to use all of these applications very well. All of the AI applications, open source applications, very well, excellent, without any issues. And meanwhile, our installer is working at the behind of the scenes. It is installing everything for us automatically. So the installation has been completed. Scroll to the top and see if there are any errors or not. And you see there are no errors. The installation were very smooth. If you encounter any issues, right click here, edit and select all, then right click, edit, copy, and then send me the entire output as an email or from Discord so I can see whether there are any errors or not. Then all you need to do is go back to your installation folder and just double click and start the application with Windows startup.bat file. It will ask you options. Depending on your VRAM, select the option. So I have 3090, therefore I have 24 GB, so I'm going to go with the default 1+1 option, which is the best option. If you have 12 GB, you can try this, but it may be slow, so you can go with 1+2. If you have 6 GB GPU, you can go with 1+3. And the application interface has started and ready to use. When you first time generate something, it will download all of the models into the Hugging Face cache folder. Currently, I already have downloaded everything. And I have another instance, so I will close it because it is using my VRAM. And where are these models are downloaded? They are downloaded into my default Hugging Face cache folder. It is inside my R drive in here. So how many gigabytes they are? They are about 20 gigabytes plus 10 gigabytes, so 30 gigabytes. If you don't know how to set your Hugging Face cache folder, I have an excellent tutorial video about it. So open this link. In this video, when you check the description and search for Hugging Face, let me show you. You will see that where I have shown how to set the Hugging Face cache folder. So you can follow this tutorial to learn more about it. And we got our output image. So we have a lot of presets that you can try. For example, let's try caricature and generate. You can also loop all of the styles and see which style is performing best. So from these values, which one you should change? You can change the width and height of the output. You can also increase decoder inference steps. This is improving the quality. I have played with a little bit prior inference steps count, prior guidance scale, and decoder guidance scale. They weren't that many good to make changes. So it is up to you to play with them and see. You can also randomize seed to get different outputs each time when you generate. Moreover, in the image metadata, you can load any image that you want, like this one, and click load and set metadata settings and regenerate the image. Okay, so click the load and set metadata settings. Make sure that randomized seed is not selected because it will use the same seed. Hit generate and it will generate the same image with the same settings. This is very useful. Actually, I find that loop all styles is very useful as well. Moreover, randomized seed is very useful as well. When you generate more than one image, it will increment the seed, so it will generate different images in each time. And you see we got the same image. Let's generate this image with another style. We have 275 styles. Let's try cell shaded art and let's generate 3 images and hit generate. Moreover, you can see what is happening on the CMD window. You see the final prompt became like this and the final negative prompt became like this. It is also showing how many images it is going to generate, and this is the current image that is being generated. As soon as the image is generated, it will be saved in the outputs folder. You can click this icon to load the outputs folder. However, if you are on RAMPod or on cloud service like Kaggle, it will not work. If you are using Massed Compute, it will work. If you are using their thin link client, I will show in the another video that I'm going to make. So you can open the generated images and look them as soon as they are generated. You don't need to wait this process to be completed. They will be immediately saved after whenever the generation has been completed. You can watch the status on the CMD window and you see images are getting generated. Each seed will generate different images as you are seeing. And all 3 images are generated. You can scroll them through from here. You can see each one of them. You can click here to download them. So let's generate with the all styles and see what is the process. Click generate and you will see that it is generating 828 images. Why? Because we set the application to generate 3 images for every style here. And the images are getting generated. So far it has generated 7 images. We can see the images here. This will take, of course, a lot of time. So you can try this at your computer and see the results. If you have any questions, any demand, reply to this video, message me from Patreon. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial that I'm going to make, hopefully in future.